Hello everyone. As you would all be aware that the 38th GST Council meeting took place on the 18th of December 2019 under the chairmanship of the Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and various other officers of the Ministry of Finance and the Finance Ministers of States and Union Territories. In this video, I shall brief you with the decisions of the GST Council, which shall be given effect later through various notifications and circulars. So we will be going through all these decisions one by one. Firstly, the GST Council has recommended the formation of a grievance and redressal committee consisting of the various CGST and SGST officers and including representatives of trade and industry and various other GST stakeholders such as GST practitioners and GSTN officials. This committee will address grievances of specific general nature of the taxpayers at the zonal and the state level. Secondly, the due date of filing of GSTR 9 and the reconciliation statement in GSTR 9C has once again been extended from 31st of December 2019 to the 31st of January 2020. Thirdly, the GST Council has recommended certain measures to improve the filing of form GSTR 1. Consequently, the late fee has been waived for all taxpayers in respect of GSTR 1 from July 2017 to November 2019, provided such GSTR 1 is filed before the 10th of January 2020. Another important decision which the GST Council has taken is regarding the e-way bill for taxpayers who have not filed their GSTR 1 for two tax periods. It may be noted that the e-way bill for taxpayers who have not filed their form GSTR 1 for two tax periods shall be blocked. They shall not be able to issue e-way bill. Another important decision is respect to the input tax credit to the recipient in respect of invoices or debit notes that are not reflected in GSTR 2A. Now, the restriction of input tax credit on such kind of invoices which are not reflected in GSTR 2A shall be restricted to 10% as against the earlier rate of 20%. The GST Council has decided to check the menace of fake invoices, and in this regard, suitable action shall be taken for blocking of fraudulently availed input tax credit in certain situations. A standard operating procedure for tax officers would be issued in respect of action to be taken in cases of non-filing of GSTR 3B. Another major development is regarding the filing of GSTR returns in northern eastern states. The due date of filing of GST returns for the month of November 2019 for the northern eastern states has been extended. Now coming to some of the important developments regarding the GST rates and exemptions. First of all, the GST Council has decided to levy a single GST rate of 28% for state-run and state-authorized lotteries. The same shall become effective from 1st March 2020. The GST Council has recommended to exempt upfront amount payable by an entity for long-term lease of industrial financial infrastructure plots, provided such entity has ownership of state government or central government to the tune of 20%. Earlier, the exemption was available to such entities who had ownership of central or state government to the extent of 50%. This change shall become effective from 1st January 2020. Thanks a lot for watching this video. We shall be discussing these decisions taken by the GST Council in detail as further details come up in the future. Thank you.